As with cities, so it is with dreams. Neither the one nor the other suffices to hold up their walls. I am dancing on a tightrope. I am walking on a trampoline. If I do not fall one way, I fall the other. If I take language too seriously, I am in an extremely bad way. Let it fall, I say. Let me tumble. And, as if on my command, a light rain falls. As I amble, lost, I tell myself, I have neither desires nor fear. Oh, how I entertain myself. Into the clearing and into the light of human consciousness emerge all those things that are discovered or encountered in the world. Ah, the rain is delicious. And I walk and I walk and I walk until, lo and behold, at the end of this narrow lane, I see the sign for Yogi Inn. Yes, the harder we try, the worse we do the thing. The whole effort must be to get out of our own light. Outside the inn, someone is washing the windows now as the rain has stopped, and I can see into the lobby. Sitting there in the cafe lounge is Shakti. She smiles, I wave. Huxley thought, following a phrase of the mystic William Blake, if the doors of perception are cleansed, everything will be seen as it is. The world is infinite and holy. Combining awareness with these various trainings and good feeling, he wrote, we may increase the sum total of human decency and make the realization of many of our latent potentialities possible. Huxley became a mystic and came to believe in a unified spiritual reality of which individual consciousnesses are only derived. He had said in one of his responses in an interview, you're assuming that the brain produces consciousness. I'm assuming that it transmits consciousness. I myself happen to believe that the deeper self within us is in some way continuous with the mind of the universe, or whatever you want to call it. But as I say, you don't necessarily have to accept this.